All right, let's do it. All right, so I think my first question is, last January, you said the main focus for the new stadium was the Arlington Heights project. What changed in June, and where's the focus now? Has it shifted more towards the city?
You know, anytime you come into a new situation, you're just gathering information. Now I've been here about 10 months, and I'm able to really have gathered, you know, information. I mean, the Arlington Heights property is incredible. I mean, anytime you have 326 acres, you know, near a major city, and now we've cleaned everything, so it's a vacant piece of land. So that's a great piece of property. That said, to be able to have optionality with Chicago, you know, I've made it very clear what I feel about Chicago. I think it's the finest city in the world. You know, very rarely, I can't think of another major metropolitan area that has beautiful lakefront that you can swim in, that's clean, near a downtown. The architecture in Chicago is phenomenal, and just the history and the tradition. And so it's just something that, you know, feels right about the Bears in Chicago, but this is a long journey and we'll continually work on it.
Well, that the report from the Crane Chicago was saying that the South Lot is an option. Is that one that you're strongly considering?
Yeah, I mean, we're looking at, you know, until we are able, and I hope it comes here in the kind of the next months, you know, here. It has to be this year, sooner than later, that we're able to say, this is where we want to do the best we can to build. There's still some options. But, you know, one good thing about Chicago, there's not a lot of options. There's a handful of them. We're still kind of running those to the ground. But if we're fortunate enough, if we're able, you know, to stay in Chicago, I would just say, you know, we need to make sure that it's close to the lakefront, because I think that's what brings it all together. I always think about, you know, those money shots of Sunday night football, Monday night football, Thursday night football, hosting a Super Bowl. You know, I visualize the day that we win a Super Bowl in our stadium in Chicago. But having that view of the lake, of downtown, you know, of that beautiful city, I think we deserve to see and explore if that's a possibility.
Well, you and Mayor Johnson have met a few times, yes. And it seems like there's been some momentum. Why do you think there's been momentum between the two of you guys since he's taken over?
Yeah, you know, I wasn't in any of the meetings before I arrived at the Bears, but I have just found if you can find, you know, common threads, commonality, communication. I've always been one of those individuals that, you know, put the other person first. And so I asked myself, just like Mayor Hayes in Arlington Heights, if I were mayor of Arlington Heights, what would be the things that would be most important? If I'm the mayor of Chicago, what are the things that are most important? So I never enter into a relationship. I don't even call it a negotiation, a relationship, asking, like, what can I get from it? You know, what can I take away from it? It's more so, if I were in their shoes, what would be the important items to consider? Focus on them. And typically, if you do that, then we'll be taken care of. And so I just think, because Mayor Johnson and I have been able to communicate as two men who are in new jobs, who want the best for the city of Chicago, who love children, who love the Chicago Bears, who love our fans, and who are incredibly grateful to God for us to be in this position that we're in, and to have an opportunity to do something that's transformative for not only for Chicago, but for the Chicagoland area. So we just have a lot of commonality.
Have you thought about what happens to Arlington Heights and that property if there's no stadium built there?
Yeah, I have thought about that. But one good thing, you know, about it is that they're not creating any more land. And if you have a really good piece of land, which it is, with good visibility and near the highway, I think in time, you know, depending on what happens, we have a long way to go with the city of Chicago. We have a long way to go with Arlington Heights. But having good land is difficult to find. And I think that would be a very interesting project to work on if we had to think what happens with the land. But as of now, I just want to make sure that we continually stay in communication. And I think it will be very, very clear to everyone involved what's the right place, what's the right location, what's the right timing, what's the right thing to do. And we just need to put our fans first.
So there's no timeline, or do you want to know something by the end of 2024?
Oh, I think the timeline, yeah, it has to be in 2024. I mean, in a perfect world, I would like to have clarity in this legislative session that's coming up. Time is money, and you know, it takes probably 3 years once you put a shovel in the ground. And so, you know, this is one of those ones, I think 24, you know, should be the focal point. You know, this is the year. And I feel that we're starting to get momentum. Even being here in Las Vegas with the Super Bowl, there have been a litany of individuals who have come up to me, fans, individuals, you know, that work even at other teams in and across the league, is to say, wouldn't it be amazing for you all to be able to get, you know, a stadium, unsolicited. And they've come and even have said, you know, can you imagine a Super Bowl in Chicago? And so I just think right now that even just the football world, you know, will feel what a new stadium could do, a fixed roof stadium, not only for, you know, the Bears, but for the NFL, college football playoff, you know, hosting the Super Bowl, Final Four, Big Ten championships, concerts, all these different events that when you think about it, that Chicago that we're losing out on because we don't have the facility to be able to do it.
Oh, that goes into my next question. It's perfect. In the letter that you sent to season ticket holders, you talked about a fixed roof and not a retractable roof. Why not a retractable roof?
You know, just from experience, when we were building U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, you know, we toured every dome stadium. And one of the things that I heard kind of over and over is that the majority of teams who have retractable roofs, they very rarely use them. It was a nice to have. And because I am budget conscious and want to make sure that we're prudent with our resources and our dollars, I think, you know, from a financial standpoint, a retractable roof, it would be a nice to have, but I would rather make sure that we use those dollars on the surrounding, you know, areas or for fan amenities that they would be able to enjoy it. But that's the main reason why. And I'm a big believer in the roof that we have in Minnesota, the ETFE that they have at SoFi, you know, they have in Minnesota. I think it works well in our climate in Chicago, and it makes it where the sun, you feel like you're sitting outside. So in order to do it, you know, you can't do a retractable roof with that ETFE.
Well, I want to talk about a little bit about what happened on the field this year. What was your assessment of Justin Fields, his play this past season, and did he live up to expectations?
Yeah. I know from my standpoint, and I come to the table, I'm a supporter of Justin, you know, because I got a chance to work with him when I was commissioner of the Big Ten Conference. He is incredibly talented. He is smart. He works hard, and he wants to be a great NFL football player. And so now he just needs to make sure that he has the support around him. He's working hard. And then I would love to see him, you know, this offseason, make sure he's totally healthy going into the season next year. You know, this is a difficult game. And if you think about professional sports, but let's talk about professional football, it's an incredibly difficult game. And then when you think about the quarterback position, it is difficult. And so, and it's, you know, Justin has a rare combination of intelligence, of size, of strength and speed. You forget how big of a man he is until you're up on him. He's not a small man. And so I just think every year he's going to continually get better. So I'm glad he's on the Chicago Bears.
I also think about Ryan's big decision to make, the whole, how much input as you go into this draft are you going to have, or is this kind of on Ryan to make this decision of whether you keep Justin or you maybe draft one of these quarterbacks that are coming out in this draft?
Yeah, one good thing about our Ryan's and I's working relationship is the fact that, you know, we're in this together. And I know he's spending every single day thinking about not only that decision, but who to draft at number 9 and our current roster, what we're going to do in free agency, what are we doing from a contract negotiation standpoint. I'm sure he's already starting to play out the draft in his mind. And so, you know, we'll work together, but I have great trust, obviously, in Ryan and our, you know, Ian Cunningham and all of our scouts. But this is that crucial time, and they've already been grinding away on it to be able to come together. So I look forward to, you know, going to the combine here later this month and then getting the chance to spend some time together because we're in a very, very unique space and time in the Bears. I mean, you think the draft that Ryan made, you know, last year to get DJ Moore and then turn that pick into drafting Darnell Wright and then Stevenson and to get, you know, those young guys a chance to play and then trade for Montez you know, Sweat, and then not only trade for him, but then extend him. And so if we can replicate, you know, back-to-back years to really be smart about how we handle our draft capital this year, it could be a really special time for, you know, for the Chicago Bears. You look at the 85 Bears, how many individuals in one draft, you know, came out of that draft of all those starters. And so I'm very cognizant and conscientious that I need to be there to work hand in hand with Ryan, be supportive, kind of challenge a thought process, but to make sure that we come out of this draft and this free agent this summer going into the year a much better football team.
In the summer, got a chance to talk with him during training camp, and he talked about how having your offices so close together,
yeah, we're right next door,
was so crucial for him. Yeah. Because you come over, sit down at the big table, and you guys would have conversations, not just about football,
right,
but about life and everything else that's going on. How has that relationship grown over this past year?
I mean, the great thing about it is that, you know, when you start making difficult decisions, the importance, and I know for me, the importance, and for Ryan, that you can get to the point where you trust that person is critically important. And I know just from my career, this is all predicated upon trust. We know, you know, he has talent. He's a good thinker. He's been with the Chiefs. He's won a Super Bowl. So he knows what it looks like. I know what it looks like from my time in the NFL, especially winning a Super Bowl with the Rams. But the biggest thing is how quickly could we get to that level of trust that what we say to each other. And the way you develop trust is time. It's time on task. And so he and I, we made a commitment early on that we were going to really work on our relationship. And it's great having another male. Both of us are type A personalities. But to be able to know that I know what I tell him, I'm telling it for the right reason. I know what he tells me, the same thing. But when we communicate, it's for the right reasons. And it almost has developed into like the feeling you have about a family member. That you know, I know when a sibling, I know when my parents, when they were alive, when they would tell me something, it wasn't for selfish reasons. It was really based upon the facts, and they wanted the best, you know, for me. And so when I go into the office every day and I look at Ryan and have that relationship to be able to communicate, it is truly a blessing. And I'm excited to say that this shows that two alpha males can work together. But if you develop trust, you're sincere with each other, that you can have a special relationship that can last for a very long time.
The way that the season started, 0-4, a lot of people started to really question, yep, Matt Eberflus. Mm-hmm. To look at how the season ended, to get 7 wins, 3 wins that kind of missed out on, you, yep, almost had double-digit, yep, wins, to see how Matt not only got this team back on track, but also turned this defense around, yep, as well. A lot of people were thinking there could have been change at the end of the season, mm-hmm, about moving on, maybe going to get another head coach. That didn't happen. Mm-hmm. The consistency there, the continuity there seemed to be evident inside of Hallis, yep, Hall. Talk about the job that Matt did this season and why you had faith that he could be the guy to lead this team to where everybody hopes to be, and that's a Super Bowl.
Yeah, I mean, I know for me, as a former student athlete, as an executive, as a lawyer, you know, looking back over your life, if there have ever been mistakes, it's because you've tapped out too early. And to really build something that will last the test of time is you have to give it time. Now, I'm not saying just an infinite amount of time, but it takes time to really build it. We were in a meeting one day, and I said to Matt and Ryan, I said, do you all realize that you've been here for 24 months. I mean, you know, when you think about it, and that, I mean, 24, and you're talking about coming from organization, so you're talking about accepting a job, moving your family, getting your kids in school, getting acclimated, new organization, and then hiring a coaching staff. It just takes time. And so I just look back over my career, you know, you have to be, you know, impatiently patient. But I just have always felt, it seems like even in businesses, that year 3 is always the year that you can really determine, kind of, are we on the right track? And I feel very strongly that we are on the right trajectory. You notice one thing that I really noticed at practice and every single one of our games, I saw when I was interviewing for the job, I purposely came to the Eagles game during the 20, it would have been the 22 season, okay? It was a cold day. The Eagles clearly were leading their division fight, you know, for a divisional championship game. I bought tickets as a fan, drove, parked, came with my daughter and some friends. And one of the things that struck me was the Chicago Bears, they battled to the very end. They didn't quit. So seeing that then, and then even last year, there were many a times, and we've all been associated with teams when individuals have tapped out. This team fought. And like you said, I mean, we were really there into the very end. So when you see that, you want to give people time. I am so pleased with the coaches that have been hired, and it will make a difference this year. And our players know the system. I mean, you think when you change a head coach, it's not just changing the head coach. You're changing assistant coaches. Then you may change the strength program. And then you may change a lot of the ways that you travel, the logistics, all the different things. And then now you start the clock, you know, over again. So I felt by getting some consistency is I think we'll have clarity, you know, in regards to this is going to be a critical year.
At your last press conference, you were talking about the long-term approach of building this franchise back up. It's been almost 40 years since the Bears won a Super Bowl and almost 20 since they appeared in one. What's a reasonable expectation for Bears fans to be able to get this team back to competing for another Super Bowl championship?
I mean, that's a great question. When you look at this, and that's one of the reasons why I was so focused on how we ended up last year, is because, you know, you get toward the end of every season, you're not only finishing that season, but you're already starting the next season. And how you end a lot of times will positively impact how you start. And we have momentum, you know, the way we ended last year coming into the offseason. So I'm pleased with where we are. All you have to do is look around the league that there have been teams. I lived it. We went from worst to first. I mean, we won 4 games, 4-12, and then go 16-3. But you look at the run Detroit have, and I'm convinced that run Detroit had this year really started in Green Bay, you know, winning that game and then carrying it, you know, over. And so one of the good things that I love coming to the Super Bowl every year is come Sunday night, all 32 teams in the NFL are going to be all 0-0, okay? It's not like you can carry over wins. It's no teams are going to start next season and have 3 wins already before we start the season. We're all 0-0. So I think it comes down to us as an organization, from ownership to everyone in our organization. Do we believe we're champions? Are we willing to put in the work to be a champion? Are we focused on being a champion? And are we put our mind toward that it's time for us to not only get to a Super Bowl, but to win a Super Bowl? And so as of Sunday night, we're all 0-0, and teams have proven it. Like I said, I lived it. So for me, I go into every year, not just in lip service, but truly expecting that it can happen. We went from 4 wins to 16 wins, that it can happen. And so I feel very good coming in this season that we got to stay healthy. We got to make some great decisions in the draft and free agency. We need our veterans to step up. We need everyone to take another step. I'm grateful that our young players played a lot last year. And then we need to stay close as an organization, keep working hard, and then have some good bounces next year. And we'll see where things go. But I feel like we're, if you ask yourself, are the Chicago Bears on an upwards trajectory, you'd have to say the way we ended, the decisions we made in off seasons, the decision we made last year, and so long as we have a really good draft and free agency, I think we'll be going into the fall next year, you know, as a team that will really have a chance to have a great season. And I'm looking forward to it.